Hello student, welcome to Vastek channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. So, so far we are discussing about interrupt in module 2. So, interrupts are classified into two types. One is called as hardware interrupt, other one is called as software interrupts. So, interrupts are classified into two types. One is hardware interrupt, other one is software interrupts. So, what is this hardware interrupt and what is this software interrupt? We have to see in today's session. So, now, there are especially three pins in 8086 that is associated with the hardware interrupt. By activating 5 volt signal on that pin, you can activate, you can invoke interrupt. Those three pins are INTR, NMI and INTA. So you can see here. This is the microprocessor, this is the interrupt controller, so 8259, this is not there in your syllabus, you study only 8255, 8259 is the programmable interrupt controller, so as soon as the interrupt comes, this interrupt controller will manage the interrupt and it will send interrupt signal to the microprocessor on this pin, interrupt request. As soon as the microprocessor receives interrupt request, the first job what the microprocessor will do is, it will send the acknowledgement for the interrupt controller saying that I have received your interrupt. After that, it will alt the current execution status and it will save whatever I told in the previous video, that is a flag register, code segment and instruction pointer to the stack and it will jump to the interrupt service routine location. So we have something called as non-maskable interrupt. So what is this non-maskable interrupt? So far what I said interrupt this one, INTR, it is a maskable. Maskable means microprocessor can ignore that interrupt. How it can ignore that interrupt? By using a clear interrupt or set interrupt instruction, we can make the microprocessor to ignore that interrupt or mask that interrupt. But if the interrupt comes on NMI pin that is not represented here, NMI pin, then that is called as non-maskable interrupt. That interrupt cannot be masked by either CLI or STI. Sometimes some interrupt cannot be masked by CLI or STI. Then INTA is the interrupt acknowledgement for the interrupt. So this is the hardware interrupt. In the exam they will ask what is hardware interrupt. That time you have to write this one, hardware interrupt. Then what is the software interrupt? Software interrupt normally invoked by the programmer in the program by calling particular interrupt number. There are different software interrupts, around 256. In your syllabus, you are going to study INT10H, interrupt related to video, and INT21H, that is DOS functions. So, before proceeding, you should know, this is not there in your syllabus, INT00, divide error, interrupt 1 is a single step interrupt, interrupt 3 is a breakpoint, interrupt 4 is a signed number overflow. These are the different types of interrupts, but it is not there in your syllabus. You will directly jump to interrupt 10H and interrupt 21H. So interrupt 21H and interrupt 10H. Now what is interrupt 10H? Interrupt 10H is related to manipulation of screen text or graphics. Interrupt 10H is related to graphics. What you can do by using interrupt 10H? You can change the color of the characters or the background color of the this one screen. You can clear the screen by using the interrupt. You can change the location of the cursor. All this done by using interrupt 10H. So now, before that, you should understand monitors. Monitor screen is divided into number of, nowadays it is called as number of pixels. Number of pixels. Pixel means picture elements. So nowadays you can see, you can set the resolution on the monitor. Resolution is nothing but 1360 into 800 or 900 or some values are there. High resolution means the picture quality is very clear. But in the earlier case, the entire monitor was monitor screen was divided into 80 columns and 25 rows. So here you can see 25 rows, 0 to 25 and 80 columns. And this is in hexadecimal value. This is the screen center. This is the value in hexadecimal. Nothing changes. So now, there are different programs are given here to clear the screen by using interrupt 10H and all. We will try to summarize this program with the single program so that it will be helpful for you from the exam point of view. So I will try to summarize this in a single program here. If you read this program, sufficient from the exam point of view. So let me zoom this one. So first one is first program we'll see here, this one. Write a program to clear the screen, set the cursor at the center of the screen. You have to remember this much only. Now to clear the screen, first of all you have to, at the end you have to call the interrupt 10H. Then to clear the screen, AX value should be 0600. 0600 means for the end, scroll the entire page. The meaning of that one is scroll the entire page. Then BH value is 07. 07 is normal attribute of the normal attribute of that picture element. Normal attribute of the picture element. Then move CX with the row and column of the top left. This one, this corner, top left. Then row and column of the bottom right, this value in hexadecimal value, it one with start with 00 and other one is starts with the 18 4f. We have seen that in the last this one, see here, this one, this value. So this value you have to load with the interrupt 10H. This is to clear the screen, this program to clear the screen. Next, to set the cursor. Once again, to set the cursor at the center of the screen, so DL. So here, I am not using CX, I am using only DL and DH. DL is 39 and DH is 12, center of the screen. This is representing the center of the screen. Other than that, with interrupt 10H and AH value is 02, that is for the cursor, to set the cursor option, and page is equal to 00, BH is equal to 00, that is for particular page. So this one you have to remember. So this is to clear the screen and set the cursor at the center of the screen. And one more is to get the current cursor position. To get the current cursor position, AH value should be 03. See here. Here in the previous program, if you write 03, then BH 00, and this is not required, followed by interrupt 10H, then that program is to get the cursor position. That means it will tell where the cursor is at particular point, at particular time, where the cursor is on the monitor screen. That is this one.